Good afternoon. I am Thomas Morris Chester. Born here in this city of Harrisburg, May 11th, 1834, my mother was born into bondage in Maryland, just across the Susquehanna River and down the road, perhaps 2 miles, rather 2 hours travel. My father had been an oysterman here in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. The two of them met, and I was born, the fourth child of Jane and George Chester. But I have been spirited back this afternoon to find out if America is holding true to the elements of the Declaration of Independence. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal and endowed by our Creator to, among those, to be life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. But not only those amendments, but also the 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendments. The 13th, of course, was granted Negroes to be free men and women, to have abolished slavery. But then the 14th, to give us citizenship and equal protection by law. And then the 15th Amendment, 1870, that Negro men will be allowed to vote. And so I have come back to see if America is still holding true to those oaths and those God-given obligations. Well, during my time here in America, I fought against slavery. My parents' house, which in this century is now the Whitaker Center, but it was their place of business. And as a young lad, as I ran around through the kitchen and watched my mother make those delicious meals, I could hear the men and women speaking about abolition. I didn't know exactly what it meant, but there was a newspaper there, The Liberator, published by William Lloyd Garrison. And when I could read, I was able to understand. And so my parents sent me around the age of 15 and 16 further north to Pittsburgh, to Allegheny College, where I was tutored by men like Martin Delaney, not just in the reading, writing, and arithmetic, but about how we were to stand up for our rights as free men of color. I then went and traveled to Liberia and spent some time there before returning back to these states to go to Thetford Academy, where I completed my high school education there. But I had become disenchanted with what America had to offer their Negro citizens, persons of color. And so I've come back to find out if voting rights are still the same. I have come back to see if there's still yet equity in education, that my children can go to the school of their choice. But I have found that yet there are still things that we still have to overcome. I heard some men talking about the idea that one has to have an ID of some kind, an identification, some form, in order to walk into the poll booths to vote. And if they did not have that identification, that they could not vote. I heard that others who may have been in prison, incarcerated, that they too could not vote. But there are those who are challenging the system. And I thank them for doing what I would have done if it had happened in my time period. And so I'm back to walk amongst my colleagues, Frances Ellen Watkins Harper, Lydia Hamilton Smith, William Goodrich, Jacob Compton, as we continue to push for the freedom and the equity in education, in voter rights, that we might be able to be a part of the society and contribute as we did for the fighting, as I saw during the Civil War. I was hired by the Philadelphia Press in August of 1864 to go with the Union Army, the Army of the James, down by the James River as we fought to push back the Confederate Army, and we did. And so after that, I'm glad to say that I continue to press forward as I receive my barrister's license and return to these states to go to Louisiana to work in the schools as a superintendent, to work as a barrister or lawyer, and to return back to Harrisburg and to be licensed here in the state of Pennsylvania. Today, in this 21st century, much has changed. Even as we stand on the doorsteps of this Thomas Morris Chester Research and Welcome Center, I pray that children of color would be invited through these doors, be allowed to read, and to gain independence. For it was Frederick Douglass who said, once you learn to read, you will be forever free. And once you learn to read, you can think for yourself, and you can aspire to be a president, as I have learned that the first man of color, President Barack Hussein Obama, became the first man of color to stand in the White House as commander-in-chief. And so that should be encouraged for all young men and women of color, that they can become what they desire to become once they learn to read. And so I thank you for coming and joining us here today. I invite you to the Thomas Morris Chester Welcome and Research Center. Bring your families, bring your children, your grandchildren. Teach them how to read. Show them that there's a world out there that belongs to them, regardless of their skin color, their race, creed. Join us. The doors are open.